Heaney and Two and Riot. I think we had about five. Hello there, Dean. How are you?
Very good.
Good. Welcome in.
Thank you.
We had about four. We had I know we had two here, and then Puahini, we lost the two in bungalows there.
Yeah, come down.
Raiatea, we lost two. Yeah, I think we have five over a period of 43 years.
What a place for your time.
That's all it's killed. It's killed.
I don't think so, yeah.
But it was the main building. It's what we lost. We had a, fortunately, we had a south wind. And it took everything out between our overwater. We had three on the left and six on the right. There was a big gap there so our boats could get in. It's such a mess because you've got the chicken wire to keep the pandanus from going, and that's just entangles, and it was just a nightmare. Welcome there, Peter. Yeah, we need to grab one chair.
Can I borrow your church key?
Yeah. You bet. You bet him. Yeah, God, I saw that guy with that thing. I was on him for 2 days. And I got it.
Jay out at the whale watching?
Uh-huh. Ooh.
Was there anything out that way?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we saw a humpback.
Oh, God, they're still here. Great. Yeah. Nobody on board. Yesterday, there were a bunch of them went out.
Yeah.
And it was just
all
black
cloudy
on the inside of a cow, yeah. Good evening.
Yeah.
Welcome, welcome. All you need is a couple of chairs here. We got plenty of room. Come in. On a 3 or 4 day holiday, our island, I think, triples. I think it goes up to about 40,000. People just pouring out, populating. I can understand it.
Yeah.
We don't have any breeze, so I hope everybody's got a little arrow guard on. So
yeah, right.
Okay,
yeah.
Good.
Yeah, they do.
There's a lot of people, they get stung. They can't. Then I put the arrow guard on them, and they can't figure why they're still stinging. They've been stung a long time. How are y'all tonight? Everything all righty? There is a restaurant called the Belvedere, just like our Belvedere Point here.
Mm-hmm.
And they will pick you up and take you up for dinner and take you back to the airport.
Mm.
There's a little, you know, the Tahiti Beach Press?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
There's a stack of them in there, right. And the ad is in there. Pick one of those.
Good spot.
Mm. Yeah.
That is makes Captain Bly is still over there, the old restaurant? Yeah.
No, not. I don't know.
Yeah.
Because I only go in 3 hours a year to get my green card. And I'm trying to find a way to get around that somehow. Get my son to do it. We've got the same name.
They don't know you by now?
Well, it's what's nice. I was in and out for a while, and the young ones that we knew were the ones that were, you know, our age or a little younger. They are all retired, and they're gone now. So the ones that are on, like when I come through customs, there's a certain way you do it. You leave your hair roaringly messed. You don't shave for 2 days. You eat a butt of garlic. You know how to fall down before you get to them. And good evening. Grab some chairs and come in. And they want to help the old guy out as quickly. They just want to get rid of him. So they fire you through the door. That's a little late. Yeah, everybody that we used to know, they're gone. We can make room for you here if you want to start the second table, whatever you'd like.
Yeah, right here's one.
Okay, great. But they won't, we tell everybody to load up on whatever you drink, because hard liquor here, if you're a hard liquor drinker, and there are not many left in the States, I'll tell you that. But if you're a hard liquor drinker, you want to be bringing it with you. We've got one wine snob. They spend 3 weeks with us and they bring 4 cases of wine. But they'll never stop you coming through. You know, they're gonna stop the Chinese because they know they're loaded. And anybody that is from here that's got a fair bit of loot, they'll stop them. But I say they don't recognize me anymore.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
It's wonderful. Cause Christ, if they catch me for all the stuff I'm bringing in, I do 20 to life. It's like when I'm coming down, there's certain things you got to work around. When a roadblock goes up, it goes up at 4 to 4:30, because the Tahitian is just blitzed about then, between that and 5:30. And then when I I'm heading home. It's between quarter of seven and seven, and it's down. So if they wail on me then, I might get a fine. Let me rephrase that. If they wail on me then, I will get a fine.
So what's on, it says happy hour with Muck, and then there's, what are the sayings on the back of the shirt?
I'm always, the people that made these for me are our timeshare folks, and I'm always saying, hi gang, come on in. So then underneath it, every once in a while, we'll do a toast. And the toast is, the liver is evil, it must be punished. Drink up. And hammered and happy. That's why I always love to get just hammered and happy before I go home. So they printed all these things, and they had five of them standing out here when I came out one night. And they gave them to me when they left. So I have one for every night. I, by myself, was dating a gal from Huahine. And this, we call them the Melon Patch Ladies, because their parents raised watermelons, and the kids, little girls, little guys, everybody, 2-3 gallon cans every morning and every afternoon. And a 3 gallon can would water 3 hills of watermelons, 3 on this side. So they were all known as the Melon Patch Gals, beautiful creatures. Tough, God, they were tough. Wow. Living out there in the jungle, they had to be tough. And I was dating a little one, and we went to Lahaina, and we went to the yacht club. Lahaina Yacht Club. We had the Leaky Tiki, and we joined the Lahaina Yacht Club with the Leaky Tiki. We had a sail on it, a Latin sail, so we could join. And we were having a big party. Big party in there. Oh, God, it was great. And it was, we were getting hungry. And my partners had already left. And I said to my Irena, I said, we're leaving now for dinner. And she just looked up and said, no. Well, I was just furious because she's sitting and looking with a handsome guy, handsome young guy, so my heart was gone. So I said, we're leaving. Then she looked up again and said, no. And she had the most beautiful hair, went down below her. So I just wrapped that around my hand and walked out the door, dragging her behind me. I got out onto the street and people were yelling, oh, that beast, hey, that terrible, hey, let that girl go, you. And now that infuriated me even more. Somebody else would get into it, and I figured it was none of their business. So I went right to the yellow line and walked right, started riding down to the restaurant down the way. And she says, sweetie, if you let me up, I'll be good. Now there was the mistake, believing her. She came off of that street, she got her hands in my hair, and she kicked the bejesus out of me. And two cops came. And they said, what are you doing to this woman? I said, Jesus, look at this, she's beating the be-Christ out of me. I need help, I don't need to be yelled at. And the one guy said, yeah, you're right. So they put her in the car and took her to jail. This was not a smart thing on their part. And I ran home and went into the apartment, locked the front door. In about an hour, there's a knock at the door. And these two cops are there, and they're shredded. Man, they're bleeding from here. And they tried to fingerprint her, so they're covered with ink. And she took that and threw it all over the place and just powered on them. They said, we're bringing her back. I said, wait. Wait a minute. She's not even mad at you, and look what she's done to you. She hates me. I'll be dead in the morning. So I said, I'm going to run into the next room, into the bedroom, and when you hear that door go click, you push her into the living room and pull the door, and you guys better get out about as fast as you can, because she'll simmer down by morning. But God, it was great. She just pounded up. And then we came in here, and I bought her a cute little jacket. And it was kind of puffy for some reason in the front. And the two big guys here said, we're going to do a strip search. And she just looked at him and said, you two guys just try that. That took care of that. They just ran her right on through. God, it was fun having a tough one.
Hey, Mark, when you come back from the States, when you visit, what do you like to bring back? What are the things that you don't...
Wall Street Journal, stacks of Wall Street Journals. Yeah. We don't get anything, and the only thing we can get here, good evening, the only thing we can get here is CNN, you know, that's Saddam Hussein's own channel. And if we could get Fox News, it'd be a different story. Welcome in, welcome in.
To the muckster.
Grab a chair.
Hey, Mark, what was Marlon Brando like? Did you...
He was the nicest guy in the world. You'd be sitting and having breakfast, and all of a sudden you look up and here's Brando. It'd be about 7:30. He'd have caught the first plane across. And he would bring all the latest movies that we had never seen. He brought them to our kids. And you guys hadn't seen them. And you wouldn't see them for another 3, 4, 6 months. But I would sit for a while, but he mumbles. I couldn't understand him. But Kelly kind of mumbled too, so they got along beautifully. They just mumbled at each other. And then he'd disappear, go out to his island, and we wouldn't see him again. For 6 months, a year, year and a half, 2 years, all of a sudden there he'd be standing there again, mumbling at Kelly. He was an awful nice guy. He really was. Good with the kids. I think he would just go out to his island and by himself, just before he had a hotel. Kelly spent months trying to talk him out of building a hotel. He said, you know, we've got to be in the hotel business to stay alive. This is a tough go, pal. But he had to have a hotel, and his island is a motu, you know, the picnic island, where it's a high point on its 8 feet. And one of the storm, you don't need a big storm. We got one every one of these storms that comes about every 12 years. The waves are big, and it took out most of his hotel. But Kelly tried to talk him. He said, you've got all kinds of money. You've got a neat island to yourself. Put up 3 brick houses and bring in your close friends. But if somebody's got their mind, you just can't even logic with them. It's not possible. But he was a good one. He had all of them. When we first had overwater bungalows, especially with a big piece of glass in the floor and the underwater lights, we were the only ones with them. The first ones were done in Raiatea by Kelly, and the next were done in Moorea by Kelly. So 78, 79, we had them up here. In our brochure, you had to do brochures back then. You don't now because you have the internet. And it pulls it out and prints things out. And our brochure said the best view from our best bungalow is through a hole in the floor. And everybody thought that was just so great, so neat. It was Kelly's idea on that, and it really brought us quite a bit of business because people want to go out and look down through the floor at night and see the rays and things that would come in. And I had a honeymoon couple that checked in, and our last bungalow was 48. And I told get baggage guy, I said, would you take him out? I'm kind of tied up. And I forgot I told him we got a big rat in there. I don't know how it got out there, but we got a big rat out there. And just as they walked through the door, the rat trap went off. Just bang! The rat hit the floor. You know how they flip for about 15 minutes or something like that? He didn't even say a word. He just went in, turned right straight around, and headed right back out, down to the next hotel. When we were kind of the only show in town, they didn't have much of a choice. And I was sitting at the bar one night, and the gal says, I can't use my toilet. I said, oh, God, I've got to unplug the toilet tonight. Wow. And I said, what seems to be the problem, ma'am? Well, she said, you better come and look. Oh, you know, let's go down and take a look. And every time she tried to sit down, there was a huge land crab in there, and he'd come up and pinch your butt. So I got a 2x4 and mushed it all up and got that one down. About the same week, next week, a gal came in and said, the same bungalow, said my bungalow 2, my toilet's boiling. I said, God, I got enough trouble down there with land crab. How could it be boiling? So I said, yes, I'm sure it is, ma'am. I'll go down and look, and it was. Because we had no water pressure in those days, nothing, just trickled. If a guy wanted to shower, you sat on the floor and tried to get water on you. And the thermostat went off on one of our big hot water heaters and blew steam and hot water back through all of our bungalows, and it was the only time in history they had hot water in the village. Okay, in a few minutes, we got about 10 minutes, they're going to do the crab races, so have your 100 frankers.
Bring your money.
Right.
Yeah, that's what it was, huh?
Yeah, you can just, yeah. When you're young, young and all day long. And you know you're going to have a date. Can I grab a chair there? Are you going to do the crab race?
Oh, you do it. I was going to ask you.
Okay, sure, sure.
Well, we're still going to when you were older. And
yeah, we're getting older.
What was the first thing that you gave up?
Well, the first thing we gave up was, I think, Raiatea sold first.
Okay. Did you sell it to someone that continued it? Or
yeah,
did it
just,
it's called Moorea. Okay, so it's still going?
I think it's called a Pearl, and now it's called TRA or something like that.
Okay.
It's made it into a beautiful hotel.
Uh-huh.
We had a land dispute with those in Huahine. We fought with them. They were two demis. Their father was American and their mother was Tahitian, and they were always fighting us because they never thought we were paying enough money, and they'd never had to work in their life, and you can understand how and why. So finally, we had two 25s. This 25 was ending, and this one was going to begin.
Okay.
So we said, here, we have the option to break it.
To break it, 25.
Yeah.
So you went 25.
So we said,
and
there you go, you just take it and do what you want with it.
Yeah.
So we just pulled out of there.
But they've continued it, and it's been sort of successful.
No, that's upside down.
Oh, that's upside
down. That went down in 1 year.
Oh,
there wasn't enough
year.
Left to water shotgun.
Okay.
What's up there?
The mouth up there?
With a hole in it.
With a hole in it.
Yeah.
You've never heard that question before.
My partner hiked up there.
I hiked up there.
Yeah? Oh, did you?
Yeah, 2 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah, we were going to rappel down into the hole and have our pictures taken, but it was too... fragile.
But
you know, it's too fragile, and the guy
said.
Didn't want to do it. So on the way down, we had an incredible rainstorm, and it washed out almost all of the trails, and it took us almost 7 hours to get down. And we were up there by 12, and I was supposed to be back here at 3. We were going to have our last meal, and then we were going to go home. And as it turned out, my wife had to pack everything up, and she sat with the cab driver, and Georgiana and Valentina, you know, just praying, where the hell is this asshole at? And anyways, we got down, they got me to the airport, and I came in just like you come out of the jungle. And it would have been a lot easier if I would have had some hiking shoes.
Been a lot
shoes.
Smarter if you hadn't done it.
Well, the thing was, I was supposed to do it 2 days before, see, but it rained.
You
so,
didn't listen to me very clearly.
I didn't.
You've been a lot smarter. I didn't.
I didn't listen to you.
In 19, I forget what it was. Which Super Bowl did Joe Namath? Was he was the third Super Bowl.
78? It was 68, it was the first, 71 maybe?
Yeah,
was it okay?
Yeah.
A bunch of guys came in, and I didn't know who they were. But I thought, God, if I can hang on to him, I can make payroll. And I heard him talking, and I finally realized they were I'll Walk a Mile for a Camel guys. Mm. And I thought, ooh, how can I hold it? And then I kept listening and listening. They said, yeah, but we haven't got a model. We haven't got a guy as tall and skinny and blue eyes we got to have. And man, I just sprang up. I said, yes, you do. Yes, you do. Well, when they took it, at the very end of it, you know, where a guy sits down and crosses his foot like this and he's got a hole in the shoe and he says, I'll walk a mile for a camel.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They put me out on the wharf out here, and the guy got got out in the ocean, and I put my foot like this with a hole in it right next to the hole in the mountain. Got it. Great shot.
Oh.
Just a beautiful
now,
shot.
Do you have any copies of that?
I don't think so. I just wish we did. We had the copy and everything, and that went down in one of our fires.
Oh.
That went down, I think, in the 71 fire.
Because I remember you talking about that before, and we tried to look it up to see if there were anything.
Yeah. You'd have to go to whoever makes Camel and see if there'd be...
Archives.
They'd have in the archives.
Around 71, though, huh? Or early 70s.
Because the hotel, it must have been 70 or 71 that it was done, because the hotel went down in 71 in the summer of 71. And we lost everything. because we'd had great things. And we had been to Bangkok. We were young and single and everything.
71?
Yeah. And, or 70, yeah, somewhere in there.
During the Vietnam War.
And we had checked three gals out on the Diners Club card, and we always had that on our wall in a big frame, and that burned up. Got it. Beautiful creatures. And I thought that was so great, being able to check out a lady with a credit card.
It looks like a woman.
Because you've got a lot
doesn't it?
Yeah. You know what? This is our fourth time here. Our fourth time here. Bruno, every single time, has pointed that out, and I always go, yeah. This morning, I sat there, and I looked, and I go, I see it.
You have to see it. That's right.
But it's like, you don't get, I mean, it took us four times.
And, you know, it looks like it looks like a native woman.
Right,
exactly.
Just laying back with her hair.
It doesn't look like an American.
No. How about the Russian that had gone up on the hike? Which mountain was it that he was climbing? Just this range here.
Have they ever found his body?
Oh, sure. They found it by smell. Good Lord. He'd been 4 days. You blow up like a poisoned dog.
You
got to get a guy on the ground quick. And they had come, he and another Russian came along and started up that mountain. And the other one said, hey, this is too tough for us. And made the other guy come back. Both of them came back. The other one showed up 3 months later by himself. And all of a sudden he was gone from the hotel. We didn't see him for dinner and didn't see him for breakfast, and the bungalow cleaner would come in and say, hey, there's nobody in this bungalow. The clothes are here, they're hanging and everything. There's nobody here. And the guy that said, this is too dangerous, called up and said, I'd like to talk to so-and-so. And we said, we haven't seen him for 4 days. He said, I'll tell you where you find him.
Oh.
You go up and check that mountain, and that's where he is. That's where he was. He'd come right off the side of it.
So he's just following a trail, or was he?
Yeah, following the trail. But as I understand, there's a spot up there that looks like it's going straight on and it goes off the side. Grab a chair here, gang.
Okay. Yeah, that's
pretty sheer.
Anybody else comes out, they can either get their own or go to
dinner.
I just can't believe how long they're staying. And they got in here real early this year. And they came in a bunch of them.
Now, have you gone out and seen them?
I'm not a water person.
It's hard out there.
We're not either.
Yeah, I'm not a water person.
He had a 27.
Hey, ma'am, Maru.
With the outriggers.
Are those yours?
No. I've had a vasectomy.
That's proof that it's necessary.
It was funny. I went up with the old pearl diver, Billy Villar, and Jay dropped me off for my clip. And he said, will you look after Billy Villa? I said, my God, I'm going to get cut, and you want me to watch this wild man? What am I going to do? So I put him in the waiting room. And it was funny. I had a mirror, one of those mirrors I could see out, and nobody could see in. And he entertained everybody in the waiting room because he'd always get on the table and sing funny Tahitian songs. And, oh, God, it was just, he was fabulous. And the guy did a quick clip on me, and I came back out, and I said, okay, we got to go look for Jay. And they have a song here. It's a funny Tahitian song. It says, basically, they just castrated a pig. So he was behind me singing this wonderful song. It went down Kalakaua.
So you had it done here on the island?
No, good God.
In Orange County?
No. I went to Hawaii.
Hawaii, okay.
Most thing you have done here, clip a little hair out of your nose or an ingrown toenail, and that's max, pal. Yeah, French doctors are not American doctors. Uh-huh. But it's a lot better than the one we had when we first got here. I went down for a tetanus shot. Funny, a guy in a little building down there, and he takes this needle out of an ashtray. It was a clean one. I mean, it was a clean ashtray. But I thought, that's kind of strange. So I kind of got my sleeve like this and put it out, and he just took the needle and just drove it right into my gut. Yeah, I'd never had a stomach tetanus before. And, wow.
Did it work?
Yeah, I think so. I think probably did. I had a booster the other day. I don't know how long a tetanus is good for.
10 years. Maybe your Tahitian.
How long?
10 years.
10 years.
Yeah. Maybe
I'm
your Tahitian was bad, and you said rabies.
Yeah.
Instead of tetanus.
This guy, he was something. He was really, God, we had strange people down here. You got your hair cut on Thursday. There was an upside down canoe, and a guy clipped your hair. You sat on the canoe, and that ran 20 francs. And the guy that we loved the most was the Catholic priest, because he had a girlfriend and two kids. He was our kind of priest. So he really, and he always stood up for us. A lot of people trying to get us thrown out of here. He always stood up for us. It was nice.
Slowly, time.
You got to realize, on an outer island like this, you cannot breathe, you cannot stop. So how excited can you get about really knocking yourself out?
But they just seem so much slower than everything.
I'll try it again. You cannot start. Yeah. So how could you move fast? Why would you move fast?
No.
The Tahitians, we have one down at the foot of the bay here, with all that heavy equipment as you're walking around down to the Chinese store. Hardest working Tahitian I ever knew. And there's another one up here, got a little store, knockout, goes day and night. But there's probably some Chinese blood in there at some point, because the Chinese will work forever. It's all they know to work, and that's why they own everything there is. They own all the black pearls, they own everything. But they work.
They're on the juice.
They're fabulous. Yeah. Fabulous. Yeah. You just got to admire them.